me a six-figure whatever, but we don't calculate what it truly takes. Are we talking six-figure in revenue, or are we talking about six-figure in profit based on our business model and structure? This gentleman got six figures that he's paying himself out of a corporation that's making, got to be making more in that in order for him to earn it. I will be the first to say, I've been in the beauty industry for over 24 years. I now do consulting. We've got to stop this madness. We are in a billion-dollar industry, and we the last one. We're the poorest ones in the industry.
All of us not get money.
It's not about jumping out there. And I'm going to tell you, God said faith without works. That means put in the work, do the research, do the study, pick up a book and read. It's too much information out here online for us to be this ignorant. And I'm just going to say it. Because we are in this together, guys. And we are. I am so passionate about it. There's millions of dollars in this room right here that we have made. And booth rental has never been a profitable business model. It is right. The only one making money in booth rent are the booth renters. As the owners, you are not making money if you still standing behind that chair. And I tell anybody, I came out of corporate first. I worked for General Motors. I worked for Pfizer Pharmaceuticals. I've worked for Empire Education Group as their first regional director and their first national director of clinic. I have put together and managed million-dollar budgets. And I'm telling you now, I've seen it for 20 years. We are not getting paid. We are giving dollars away. We have to start planning like corporations plan. You do not see the president of Coca-Cola down there on that fountain line making no pop.
I got a question. Anybody know a minority owner that owns over 100 salons? Like a sports group, great place? Why?
There you go. Why?
It's really about this conversation. Is
that's
why.
It.
Nobody spends more money on out here than us.
Than us. And
nobody.
Everybody.
It's recession proof. We get our hair cut every week. Our counterparts, they may come once a month.
Right, or every 6 weeks.
Why we don't have what they have is what we got to challenge ourselves to deal with that, like on the face of it, until we get it together.
Guys, I'm telling you, there's
so much knowledge in this room. I got more here. All right, so let me touch this right quick. I need everybody in this room to really understand what networking is, because some people network and some people's idea of networking is shaking a man's hand. And get his eyes and that network. What networking really is I came to a class at his shop. So I paid $200, learned something from him. And from that $200, I built a relationship with Ray. So I met with him and probably like six other people. And so what you got to do is, when you get the Instagram and you get their business card, you got to call them. You got to email them. You got to inbox them, direct message them in that relationship. And from that relationship, like I said, I didn't actually meet him there. I met him through watching his online university. I bought his university for whatever he charges. I'm not going to be numbers no more. Whatever he charges. Saw a video on him, saw him at National Barber Business Symposium 3 weeks ago. Said, hey, will you come be on this panel? Because I like what you're doing. You're doing the units, killing it, doing the marketing, killing that. He about to open up his own shop if he hasn't already. So he's working on that. And I never reached back out to him. So when I posted it, he said, oh man, I forgot. But he got the level of integrity he got. It's like, yo, even though I wasn't coming, I bought my plane ticket, I'm on the way right now. You know, say I met this dude once. so please, you know, share a little something, whatever's on your heart about the dude, whatever. Share something. I can't let that man fly in like
that. So I just want to get on, you know, my specialty, which is marketing, advertising, stuff like that, networking. And Valdez is on Instagram. Basically, guys, the only reason I'm on this panel is because of network marketing and just advertising. That's my specialty. That's what I do. So, coming in the game, you guys, I'm 22 years old. Starting off, I've been a professional barber for almost 4 years now. And all I've done is invest in myself and advertise. So I was that kid that went to every class. Every class that there was, I was there. And no matter what the cost, no matter where it was, I've been to everybody's class. Yeah. So just networking, and like I said, networking, advertising, and just reinvesting that money. So the classes that I went to, I've gained enough knowledge to where now I can educate others. Now, starting off as an educator, you know, when I first started, I was 21. You know, you feel like, you know, I'm too young, you know, all the students are older than me, like what can I teach them? I didn't expect to be successful. But what I didn't realize is because of I've invested so much. Sometimes guys, if you go to a lot of classes, you don't really realize how many classes you go to and how much knowledge you pick up. So I've went to so many classes that my first class and every class I've ever done has grossed at least 5 figures. And this is just off of networking and advertising. I went to Erskine is my mentor. I went to like 3 of his classes. You know, these are hair units. Now when you advertise and when you were networking for yourself, you want to do something that's gonna keep people talking. The only difference between me and anybody in this room is that because more people might know about me, but we're all talented. We all have talents. And you just gotta get yourself out there. You know, some people might be better, a lot of people are better than you, you know? But I just try to make more people know about it. So when I advertise, I try to stay ahead of the curve. You know, not just as a young person in the game, but just in general, we have to stay in the curve. We have to stay ahead of the curve. We have to stay innovative, or the industry will leave you behind. Any new service that you might think might be profitable for your business, you need to hop on it. Because just like any other business, once you hop on it early, you're gonna be more profitable. I've been doing hair units for 2 years. I hopped on it early. Now everybody's hopping on it, and I can teach it, you know, because I hopped on it early. So anything that I can do, a client of mine might not even want a hair unit. It's people, I'm from Houston, guys. There's barbers in Houston that literally give me their clients. They don't want no unit, but they're just talking about me to their client about, yeah, he do hair units. Oh yeah, who? They go to my Instagram and they book me for a regular haircut. So you just gave me your client because you're talking about a different service that you're not doing, you know? So it's not even about that. I do teeth whitening. I have a 2-chair studio. My other chair is for teeth whitening. You know, you can't have it by the hair. But this is a service I charge $150 for, and it takes me 40 minutes, and I just watch them get their teeth whitened. You know, I try to get as much money for my time as possible. I've only been a barber, professional barber, for 4 years, and, you know, and it feels like 20, you know, I need to get my money's worth for my time. You know, my time is something that we can't get back, guys. And like I said, it's not just advertising, it's not just wearing shirts, it's not just networking some amazing people that we meet every day. It's about doing different things that's gonna keep people talking. And if you go to Houston and you talk barbers, they're gonna be talking about me because I'm doing different things. I'm doing teeth whitening. Ain't nobody else, no other barber in Houston is doing teeth whitening. So once they find out, hey, my barber do teeth whitening, your barber do teeth whitening, I might not need my teeth whitening, but I want to see what he's about. I want to go, you know, so now you build a brand that has outgrown the two-man shop. Now you saved up enough money, so now you start networking and meet people. When you go to your first big shop, which is what I opened up in, grand opening is in July, but I started to build out in May. But when you save up enough money, now you can open up your big shop. You done already got the game. I don't have to bump my head with the booth ring. I already got the game in here. You know, if you want to build a strong brand and get your money's worth and build other people's brand along, you know, alongside of yours, then, you know, you already got the game. The commission, everybody, we all know that commission is, you know, the key. So I'm just blessed and happy that, you know, I've shook in the right hands in my short career. And opening my first big shop in a couple months, you know, I don't have any hiccups. I'm a high school dropout. After my 11th grade year, I had a lot of family, should I break it down? From age 10 to 15, my dad went to prison, you know, and he was really influential in my life. And you know, 10 to 15 guys, that's as a young man, that's very important. Those are very important times in your life. And when he got out, you know, when he was in, I was doing good, you know, A's, B's or whatever, you know, struggling single mom, but I was still doing great. And when he got out, you know, he was so involved in my life and so, and like, he was still there for me. He wanted to just hop right back in my life. But as a 15-year-old rebellious kid, you know, I did the opposite of everything that he told me to do. Like, do good in school. I'm already doing good in school. You can't tell me what to do. My grades dropped. You know, and it was just a cycle to where I got a juvenile record, and I decided that high school wasn't for me. You know, it was always something that, which is why it's near and dear to my heart now about kids and their grades or whatever. Because, you know, like I said, I'm a high school dropout. The only reason I'm on this panel, guys, is because of these guys on the panel. You know, taking me under their wing, people be like, oh, you're so wise for your age. It's because I talk to these guys more than I talk to my friends. These are my friends, you know? Your net worth is your net worth, you know? Your net worth is your net worth, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, so like, I talk to them more than I talk to anybody else, so I don't have to bump my head and make some of the mistakes that they made in business, you know? So, yeah, my education, you know, the traditional way, I have 11th grade education. But as far as investing in myself and being passionate about my industry, I've been to countless classes.
First off, this is just amazing. I want y'all to give a hand to everybody who's already spoken. I think the good thing about this is that I can actually be up here in this panel and tell you guys that I'm actually learning myself right now. Like, a lot of times people would think that because you get to a certain status that your mind to like learn and grow and develop has to stop once you start teaching. But once you start teaching, you have to continuously learn. So right now, I'm even learning. Like, I'm in a booth rent situation. I love my barbers. I love the situation that we got going on. But I'm hearing everything these guys are saying. I'm still trying to find the nice mix. But, and then I also find in the same situations, myself in situations where trademarking stuff happens. Like, I'm too one of the top, one of the top barbers in the game. And if you're not watching yourself, you will get got. Know who's in your chair, man. We got lawyers, doctors, financial advisors, planners, popes. We got everything. The Pope is the Pope, all right? Like, you know. Oh, for the whole year. But your hands left after that. But I really want you guys to like really understand where you at. Like, it don't matter where you get to, like, you have to have some mentors in your life that are gonna like really pour into you. You have to not even have pride to think that you can't be someone who has to go through situations where you have to learn yourself. If you're an entrepreneur, which we all are, you're going to make mistakes. Like, all of these people up here, me included, have made grave mistakes. Like, I should quit. I should just quit barbering. I'm just going to leave this over here, and I'm just going to go sell something. I don't know, you know, some rebar juice or something. Shout out to Mr. Solaire, my homie in the back. That's what he'll die. But I just really want y'all guys to understand, you know, like, I actually sat today, and I went to church. I was a little late, but the pastor said something that was just so impactful. And it made me have to like literally run to the thing. So I'm gonna do this real quick. And as I'm doing this, I'm gonna explain to you what's happening. All right. All right. You give these. You leave them. Get these around. Take them. Get these around. Take them. All right. The reason why I gotta give y'all something is because like a lot of times we never like really leave with, you know, anything. We just like go about our ways and just hear something and don't really know what's happening. Boom. Hand right there. Hand right here. Hand right there. Exercise with people in the front right now, the ones with the balloons, right? All right. Stretch it out. Stretch it out. Stretch it out. Like right now, man, I'm telling you right now, God is stretching you guys out right now. for y'all to even be in this room, for your mind to be gathering what is gathering. This is what happens. Sometimes you get stuck in these strong positions where you like don't know how to like get through it. Like you really don't know what you're doing, all right? Blowing it. All right, stop. Now the visuals I want to say is like, all the time we think that we like, we running against everybody, but look at this, bro. Like, whenever you get a good idea, God is giving you breath to blow into that idea. It's up to you what you put in that idea. Everybody's going to have to be going at a different rate. Like, his success is different than my success. His success is different than my success. His success is different than my success. His hustle, his mentality is different than my hustle and mentality. So I want you guys to always remember when you had these like balloons, you let it out, it's all good. Start that sucker back over. That's the process in the life of an entrepreneur. You gotta keep going, you gotta keep pushing life, you gotta keep breathing into your business, you gotta keep breathing into your mentality. You gotta keep going stronger and stronger and harder when people say you ain't gonna do it. You gotta keep doing it, man. So that's all I say. My name is Mark Tyler.
When I sat down with him and his partners,
catch yourself with somebody you look up to.
Be exposed and be very, very successful. So I took that knowledge and I basically just duplicated it. So right now, I have a total of 6 barbers right now. Also, I have a salon attached to that. I'm having some challenges with my salon right now. So what did I do? I hired a consultant about 2 weeks ago. Somebody who has a lot of experience, somebody who can help grow a salon, somebody who can help go out and recruit young students who have a burning desire to help grow my business. Touching on what Erskine said, right now I have a blended shop where you can actually do commission, a co-mission, and a booth rent, because everybody is not established right now. So right now I'm learning right now. So I've had some ups and downs and challenges, but all I can say to you is be fearless, man. Have a burning desire. Go out and have a desire to just make it happen every day. Instagram and social media is something that didn't happen in the 90s and the 80s and the early 2000s. We have a platform where it's free. It's free marketing. It's no excuse why we can't go put a t-shirt on and put our Instagram handle on the back. It's no excuse why we can't have a barber cake with our Instagram handle on. Every time, what I focus on is somebody seeing me coming and going, if you look at me right now, I got on something right now that says Trey Trims, Trims and Coastal, where I'm branding myself all the time. If you go on Instagram, you're gonna see me posting every 3 hours. Because I want to eat. I want to make sure that the people who's attached to me is eating. I want to maintain a certain image. That's big. You know, if you want to make money, you got to look like money. Look at me.
Get that top.
Nothing is wrong with a t-shirt every now and then, but you want to look like money. Look at my mentor, Jermaine. You know,
look at him.
I'm just making an example on how you can actually attract a certain amount of a person to you where you can make the amount of money that you want. And also, we all know that we're in a fast growing industry. The trends are changing. Erskine changed the game with the hair units. This young man attached himself to that at an early age. He's only 22 years old. He's ready to open his own shop. I'm doing it now. I don't want to be the world's greatest haircut. You know what I mean? I don't want to be in there cutting 20, 25 heads no more. I talked to Jermaine a few weeks ago about a class that I was getting ready to invest in Jermaine's class. He gave me a quote. You know, I'm not afraid to reach out to invest in myself because I know at the end of the day, the return is going to be greater. I just talked to my mentor, Jermaine, the other day about, hey, let's try to bring something back to the school. Let's try to show the school how